What's going on, guys? It's Danny with Gear Candy, and I have finally made the investment into 3D printing. Now, to be honest, cost is what's been keeping me from actually diving into this world, but recently I came across this printer from Monoprice. It's only 200 bucks on Amazon. It fluctuates between $200 and $220. For 200 bucks, you definitely got my attention. So we're gonna go ahead and open this thing up right now. So this is probably the biggest box I've unboxed on the channel so far. I actually expected a much bigger box given it's a 3D printer, but I think it's also meant to be really small and compact. So that's actually a plus because some of these 3D printers are huge. So let's go ahead and open this thing up here. So first we've got a little thank you card here. Thank you for your order, for additional information, blah, blah, blah. One of the first things we have is some filament. This is the media that you actually use to print 3D objects. One of the fails in ordering all of this is I didn't order any filament. Next, looks like a power adapter. Let's open this up. Okay, it looks like that's the 3D printer itself. Let's see what's in this box. In here we've got, looks like a USB, a micro USB cable, SD card, and a little Allen key wrench. Looks like the power cord for the power adapter, a metal piece of some sort, and looks like a spatula thingy. All right, so there you have it. This is the Monoprice Mini 3D printer. I had it left at the table so you can get a better look at this thing. First impressions, I can tell you guys, this does not feel cheap, like a cheap product. It doesn't look like a $200 product. Everything's metal cased. There's hardly any plastic on it except for maybe these little motor parts up here. Yeah, it's pretty impressive for 200 bucks. Now, I've seen other 3D printers where the platform's a lot bigger, but those go for a lot more money. We're talking about thousands. For 200 bucks, of course, the platform itself where you can 3D print stuff is not gonna be as big, but I think this is adequate for just little knickknacks to sort of get into 3D printing for the first time. All right, guys, so I got the 3D printer all hooked up here. I had to kind of rearrange everything. I've got filament already installed. It's preheated. I had to add a third camera so you guys can get a better angle of this. So we're at the point now where we can set a test print job to run straight from the printer. So that's exactly what we're gonna do right now. All right, so let's go into the print menu. It's gonna access that micro SD card. And it says to print the cat G code file. So let's see what happens. Oh, we've got some movement. All right, it's setting down the print head. Looks like it's doing some sort of calibration. So this is the first time we're printing on this thing, so I have no idea if it's gonna come out good or not, but we'll see. Looks like it's going along pretty well, so we're gonna go ahead and let this run and come back once it's finished. All right, guys, so it is now the next day. This thing took about 3 hours or so to print. You can see there's not much filament left. I actually was able to go buy some more filament today, so we'll definitely be doing some printing today. Let's go ahead and try to take the model off of the platform now. I have no idea how difficult or easy this is gonna be. Okay, let's break it off. So there is the model itself. As you saw, I had to just kind of break it off that platform. Looks like the initial layer is really on there. I'm probably gonna have to peel off that tape in order to take that off. But just from looking at it, this is a lot higher quality than I was expecting. I don't see many mistakes on it, to be honest. I mean, there's a few little ridges here and there that are not in place, but overall, pretty good. I mean, for a $200 printer, again, I'm gonna just keep going back to that price, 200 bucks. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. Do you have the mini 3D printer from Monoprice? Do you have one of their other printers? I actually started doing some research. Like I said, this was a bit of a gateway printer. Spent almost my whole day today researching printers, so I already have my sights on perhaps my next printer. But so far, I think I'm gonna be able to get quite a few decent prints out of this printer. But if you guys own one, let me know in the comments what your experience has been. Let me know if there's any sites I should be looking at. I heard some really good Facebook groups out there for this printer that I'm gonna be searching for. So let me know if you guys have any tips that you wanna share with me, any gotchas, how long you've owned the device for, and how it's worked out for you. So don't forget to like the video, guys, if you're enjoying the content. If you're already subscribed, don't forget to hit that notification button. If you like what you're seeing and you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing. It helps me out a lot.